These latest Canva updates are so mind-blowing. Whether you're a content creator or a business owner, these new Canva features are going to revolutionize the way you design by speeding up the process and giving you possibilities that you won't be able to live without. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. This is part two of my most recent Canva tutorial / Canva tips and tricks video, so make sure you watch part one as well, either now or right after you're done with this one. If you found a tip you liked, feel free to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos like this one. And now let's get right back into the video. All right, our next update is Beat Sync. Now, this one is so, so cool, and I love that Canva actually introduced it into their toolkit too. Basically, when you use Beat Sync, it seamlessly syncs your video to music beat. And again, with just a few clicks, all about efficiency in here as always. So let's jump into an example kind of template of a video. To use Beat Sync with your own audio file, you can just upload it to Canva. Let me just drag mine into it. So here it goes. And you can then add it to your timeline. As you can see, it just popped up down at the very bottom in here. And from here, I can just select my track, go to Beat Sync here at the very top, then click Sync Now and wait for the results. As you can see, it worked very quickly. So you can see the little markers on the timeline and actually all of the different clips adjusted to fit the beat. So it synced it. Of course, from here, if you want any adjustments, for example, if you want to make this video a little bit snappy, you can always drag the sides of the clips and they actually snap into place with the marker, making the video perfect. So I can just keep kind of doing that for those clips. And yep, I think now I'm sorted. Now I want to show you another cool part about Beat Sync. All of the audios that are already available within the Canva library, they can access from here, have already been processed and the markers are there. So there's no analysis needed. I'm just going to drag this one onto my timeline right here. Okay, so the audio is adjusted in here. And now I can go to Beat Sync at the very top. Go to Sync Now. You can see that the markers are here, but it just adjusted all of my clips automatically and timed them to the music. And I love it. I hope you love it too, because it just has so much potential, first of all, to speed things up for us while editing, and second, to help us create more engaging videos as well. Now, this one is a pro-only feature, I'm afraid, but you know what's not? Update number 8, Draw. We've seen Draw in a beta version for quite some time now, but it's officially launched now in its final version and it's so, so good. So to access it, simply go to the panel in here, choose the Draw tab, and here the little toolkit pops up with the pen, the marker, the highlighter, and the eraser. To quickly demonstrate to you, let's choose the marker in here, and below you can actually change the color. So I'm just going to go for white. You can change the thickness from here and the transparency as well. So I'm going to choose this kind of medium thick one, and I'm just going to draw two quick elements like this. That's super simple, right? But well, there's definitely much more to it. I can now choose this little cursor in here to select both of my elements, and they act exactly like any element from the library. This means I can make them bigger, I can kind of rotate them from here, I can even go and animate both of them like this. I can create an animation with them if I wanted to, just like that, and you can see they're kind of both moving. And probably the best part of it is that you can actually select them and change the color after kind of the fact, after actually drawing them on. So that is an amazing, amazing improvement to the Draw tool. Update number 9, gradients, layers, and grids. And may I just say, finally, that's what you've been waiting for. And if you agree, drop me a finally in the comments as well, so that I know you're just as excited as I am and just as excited that the wait is finally over. I want to do a very brief breakdown of these three because I'll talk about them more in around 2 weeks in my Canva tips and tricks part 4 video. So make sure you're subscribed, and let's start with another update in here. Let's start with gradients, which live in the color settings. And I want the square with a gradient, so I'll go here, scroll down from the top, and you can see the gradients in here. Now, you may think it's quite limiting, but don't worry, simply click on any, go back up and choose this Add New Color panel. And from here, you have all of your gradient settings available. I'm just going to make this a little bit bigger and position it to the top so that you can see everything very clearly. But I'm going to go back again, add color from here. You can change the style of the gradient like this. You can also change the colors from here as well. Super cool. What a change that we've got finally. And we definitely needed that one. Next, we have layers, which, oh my God, I'm so happy about. We can click on any of the elements available in here. I've got my kind of changed rectangle gradient. You can click on position here at the top. And in the left panel, we now have arrange and layers. If you click on layers, you can just simply rearrange them from here. And it's just easier to select any of the hidden elements as well. And of course, you will be able to find those hidden elements without resorting to the click plus control trick, which I've shared in my very first installment of my Canva tips and tricks videos. And let's not forget about the grids as well. If you go to file here at the top, then go to view settings and go to add guides, you'll be able to choose between a 12 and a 6 column setting. Then you can choose a 3x3 grid or go straight for custom, yay, and create your own. I love this. I think it's super cool that we have those controls now. Plus, I have to say it here, we now have guides available in the mobile app as well, which is a godsend, and I was so impatient for this one to finally pop up on my phone too. All right, here comes a big one, update number 10, the Brand Hub. The brand kit that we all know and love just got a major, major upgrade. We now have a full-on brand hub because it literally is the home for our brands, and it can contain multiple brand kits here. Apart from the classic logo and the palette and the font options, which we now have much more power over, you can now add photos, you can add graphics and icons to it too. This definitely makes for much more kind of well-rounded brand identity possibilities. And another great update here is that you can actually add your own brand guidelines to make sure all of your team members are on the same page and actually understand how to use or how to not to use all of the assets within the brand kit. Each of the brand kits within the brand hub can be added to a specific folder, which is amazing for organization and a better workflow. And of course, the brand kits with all the assets and the brand templates are available from within the editor too. So if I click in here and go to brand hub, I have all of my, again, brand templates. I've got my brand kit in here with all those details mentioned, making it even easier to stay on brand. There are also updates in terms of the controls that we have over our brand as well. So let me get back to the brand hub like this, and you can click on brand controls in here, and administrators and brand designers have controls to limit the use of colors from here. So these will be specific to the brand kit specified in kind of for that specific team. They can also enable design approval from here as well. Of course, font control is available like this. And from the design approval, if you click on the settings in here, this means you can designate an approver or two approvers, and then you can check the designs before they get published. There's also kind of flexibility whether the approval is required or encouraged. There are different conditions as well. So these controls are kind of as tight or as loose as you need them to be. And honestly, the Brand Hub deserves a separate video all on its own to explain how much more capabilities we now have to kind of both protect and implement our brand image across the board. Also, I've been thinking about creating a video on how to keep a consistent brand image online. So if you'd like to see it, please let me know in the comments down below. It really helps me a lot to hear your feedback before I dive in and actually produce my videos. Okay, let's speed things up with update number 11, new photo editor. Yes, you've heard me right. We now have a new and upgraded photo editor in Canva. When you select your image, go to edit photo here at the top, and you should actually be prompted to enter a new editor. I've obviously already tested it. And from here, starting at the very end, we have new crop capabilities. I'm not going to explain too much in here because it's pretty self-explanatory. So let's move on to the adjust tab. And it now has three areas of focus, which you can toggle from here. I love this so much because it means that the AI analyzes the image and actually separates the object from the background and allows you to actually adjust them separately. Want a darker or a colder background? Easy peasy. I can just do that from here and our object is going to pop a little bit more. I can just go back to foreground. I can adjust the brightness slightly. So it just changes different areas of the image. It's so cool. Now, jumping to effects, something I have to mention is that for the time being, we seem to be missing the shadow options, which I definitely use on a daily. I hope it's just a temporary adjustment after the launch and we'll get them back here soon. But if you're wondering where to find them, you need to get back to the old editor in here by clicking right here. You can just go to revert to the old editor. And as you can see, you can now access those shadows from here. Of course, you can see now the invitation to check out the new panel. So I'm going to click back. And I'm glad to say that our favorite feature is still very much here, the background remover, and we've got the effects like duotone and blur. I'm sure more will be migrated here soon. And also during our workshop with the Canva product managers in Sydney before the Canva Create event, by the way, incredible people. Shout out to Tiana, to Hannah, and to Tom. You guys have been amazing and it's been so good to meet you. They've explained the effects are going to be much better than in the old editor because you'll be able to apply them many times and adjust them constantly. You may remember that before we'd only be able to apply an effect, then hit done, and we'd never be able to get back to those controls to fix things. So that's a really great improvement. Okay, but you may already see the two new features lurking in the toolkit, and these are the next updates I've got for you. So update number 12, Magic Eraser. If you're a content creator of any kind, you're going to love this feature. Have you ever wished you could just remove an element from a photo? Well, now you can with the Magic Eraser, and all it takes is to just adjust the size of your brush, select the parts that you don't want, like this cup right here, and Canva will magically remove them for you. Now, whether you want to be the only person in the photo, you're annoyed by some unnecessary distraction like a power socket or a cable, or you just simply need a bit more negative space to fit your text nicely on the design, this tool is going to be your favorite. And of course, as I've just mentioned, if you're not happy, you can get right back in, keep erasing, or select reset erasings here at the very bottom, and you're back to the original. And now one of my absolute favorites from this Canva Create, update number 13, Magic Edit. To say that I was blown away when I found out about it and tested it in Sydney, it would be an understatement. This is such an incredible feature. It works so great and it can potentially save us a lot of time while browsing for specific image assets. Imagine you find a photo in the Canva library that just matches the style of your design almost perfectly, but there's a caveat. What it depicts is not quite the visual you were looking for. Let's take this photo right here. I don't want just the eggs in the bowl. I want it to clearly show we're making a cake. Where's the flower, right? Well, let's add the flower. Select the image, click Edit Photo, and from here, choose Magic Edit. Let's now brush over the size that we want to edit out. Just like this. And then we need to hit continue. Next, I need to tell Canva what I want. So instead, I want a small mound of flower. Of course, you can choose the inspirations from here, but I'm just going to go ahead, generate, and wait for the results. We're then given four variations to choose from. And I think this one is just what I wanted. Let's hit done and that's it. Isn't this like absolutely crazy? It's one thing to generate whole images using AI, but to be able to swap things up within existing photos so seamlessly is just on another level to me. I've used this one so much in the last week and I have to say it's never failed me once. Honestly, like not once. And I might have needed to generate another four or improve a prompt just because I fancied, you know, a different color flower or something. But as far as Magic Edit goes, it's done its job brilliantly every single time. What a time to be alive, honestly. Which one of these new updates is your favorite? Tell me in the comments and let me know which feature I should create a full tutorial on first. Make sure you watch this playlist right here for all the exciting Canva tutorials I've already shared, and I'll keep it updated with my upcoming videos too, so you can come back to it for new releases. That's why it's best to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell to never miss a new exciting Canva update or a new opportunity to learn how to make your content better. Thank you so much for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you next time.